FM News. On point. The news on XFM, I'm Chris Tim. The High Court has adjourned the much-anticipated ruling of a case in which members of the former National Unity Reconciliation and Development Party, NURP, are accusing their former president, Moses Tshibalama, and MP Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu of illegally changing their party name to the National Unity Platform, NUP, without their consent. Judge Musa Sekana, who has set to deliver his ruling on the contradicting affidavits of NURP founders Tshibalama and Paul Kagombe, has adjourned the ruling until Wednesday of next week. The Duo first informed court that the party's name was legally changed to NUP, which saw the MP Kyagulanyi being elected as its president, but later changed their evidence, saying that they forged paperwork, including minutes, resolutions, and a list of meeting attendees to the Electoral Commission for purposes of changing the party's name to NUP. The two were also cross-examined in court and maintained their evidence that their old party was not changed as per the law. In the main case, which has not been heard yet by the court, NURP party members led by Basil Diffas and Hassan Twaha want their party name to be reinstated back to NURP from NUP. The mayor of Nakawa Division, Ronald Balimwezo, has launched a battle against land grabbers around the city. Balimwezo launched the battle after being nominated to contest as a member of parliament for the newly created constituency of Nakawa East. He says that Nakawa has been greatly affected by land grabbing and says he is set to fight once he assumes office in 2021.
I want to make sure that I fight land grabbing. Even right now, I'm from the courts of law. Perhaps I would not be here if I was not picking up. I've been here because of the grace of God. People wanted even to clobber me along the way. That's the reason that you saw me coming silently. So as a member of parliament, I'm going to make sure that I fight for people as regards human rights.
Meanwhile, Balimwezo says that he has decided to upgrade to parliament to easily represent the electorate of Nakawa East.
As a member of parliament, we have four roles to play in parliament. One is the oversight role, the other one is representation, then legislature, and lastly, make sure that there is value for money. Therefore, I'm going to do all those roles with all my might.
Kampala Capital City Authority has certified 400 schools to reopen in Kampala. This after President Yoweri Museveni directed schools, tertiary colleges and universities to reopen for candidate classes and finalist students. The Director of Education in KCCA, Juliet Namudu, says that schools have fulfilled the guidelines and the standard operating procedures set by the government to protect the students from contracting COVID-19 while at school.
400 schools in Kampala are receiving their certificates, allowing them to teach. We have worked with very many partners in our 79 government-aided schools to train the COVID-19 coordinators who are in charge of all these activities in all the schools in Kampala, both government and private. We have availed the schools with washalots and hand-washing facilities, and we are very sure that they're all very ready. To the schools, please do not overcharge the parents, because it's a very, very difficult situation that they're in.
Namudu revealed that all the government-aided schools have started receiving part of their capitation grant amounting to 1.5 million shillings to be used in purchasing of COVID-19 equipment and disinfectants.
All the schools, the 79 government-aided schools and the high schools and the tertiary institutions have received from government, on top of their capitation grants, part of their capitation grants, 1.5 million shillings to use in availing themselves with all some of the standard operating procedures, materials that they need. Things like the temperature guns, the foot hand washing facilities, jig and other disinfectants.
School head teachers are worried of how they are going to run the term after many of the parents taking back their children to school without making any payments. Fred Lubuama, the headmaster of Victor's Junior Christian School, Mukono, says that although the turn-up is promising, many parents are saying that they have no money because they have not been working. Schools officially opened yesterday for the candidate classes following a presidential directive in his last speech.
We have had a challenge with our parents in terms of paying school fees. Most of our parents come with requests that we allow their children to report without any fees deposit because they don't have the money as for now. And the biggest challenge comes from the parents who have been school dependents, such as teachers and other suppliers of schools. They have not got the money yet they have candidates to report back.
In world news, France has reported a large jump in new COVID-19 cases ahead of a nighttime curfew being imposed in Paris and eight other cities on Saturday. A further 30,621 infections were confirmed on Thursday, up from 22,591 the day before. The World Health Organization, WHO, has warned that tough restrictions are absolutely necessary to save lives. Millions in Europe have been told they must live under strict new measures as governments battle a second wave. From Saturday, socializing indoors will be banned in London as the UK capital and other areas of England will be put under a higher COVID-19 alert. In sports, Chelsea midfielder Victor Moses has completed a season-long loan move to Russian side Spartak Moscow. Spartak said the loan includes the option to buy. The 29-year-old Nigeria international had spells on loan with Fenerbahce in Turkey and the Italian giants Inter Milan last season. He has not played for Chelsea in more than 2 years, and this is his sixth spell away from Stamford Bridge after he arrived in 2012. And that's the latest XFM News.
XFM News on point.